call to the gentleman? Can you come to this? Could you come to this side, please, so that you can do some stuff on the court then? Just there. Over here.
There, there, there.
Oh, a little bit closer. Yeah, that's it. Thank you. Thank you. Players, please. Ready? Thank you.
We're back at the final match of the quarterfinals here at the Scottish Open Grand Prix at the Emirates Arena in Glasgow.
Ladies and gentlemen,
return
on my right,
to our streaming
Christian
court
Lind
here.
THOMSEN, Denmark.
In blue, Christian Lind THOMSEN was victorious here
and
live on
my
cameras.
Left, WANG TZU WEI, Chinese Taipei.
In his earlier third round match against
WANG TZU WEI to serve, love all, play.
What is my now favourite to lift the men's single title? WANG TZU WEI of Taipei. It's been very strong so far in this tournament. With the demise of Eric Pang earlier due to injury and only a couple of seeds left in the top half of the draw. For me, there's only one man that could probably trouble him. And there are two men that could probably trouble him in the remainder of this tournament, and that's probably Ville Lang and Anand Pavar, previous winner, of course, the Indian.
Yeah.
But certainly the way WANG TZU WEI has been playing this last couple of days, I put him in as favourite to lift this men's singles title. Not with a shot like that, I'm afraid, but when he's up against Christian Lind THOMSEN. Lind, who came through that 70-minute match in the earlier round against Toby Penty in three games, 21-14 in the third. And WANG himself hasn't dropped a set en route to this quarterfinal.
There's one quite interesting thing here, Mark. Kenneth Jonasson is coaching on a doubles match on the next court. I'm not coaching the Danish men's singles player here. That's quite unusual.
Well, it's not really, because the men's doubles are national team players.
It's because Lind's not in their
national
squad.
Lind is not in the national squad and has not been for many, many years.
So do you think, is he here entirely under his own steam?
Christian Lind, yes, for sure. Yep. Mm.
4-2.
The way it works in Denmark, sometimes the players get supported by their region and get funded by the region to go to a certain number of international events per year. And that's where some of the funding comes for these non-national team players.
Yeah.
3-4.
Because they have so many quality players, it's almost difficult to tell who's actually in their their national squad and who isn't.
David Daugaard and Matthias Christiansen, the pair you're talking about on the adjoining court, European junior silver medalists.
Service over.
with men's singles in action here live on our streaming court. Christian Lind, probably the man who goes through most tournament shirts in a tournament. Changes shirt every set. You'll see that
six,
here.
Three.
After the first set, it looks like the frame gone on that racket.
It does, yeah. Point.
The crowd just starting to thin out a little bit. Getting late, approaching 9 o'clock in the evening.
Over.
7-4. So 7-4, Wang leads. Beautiful brush.
Tremendous, yeah.
Nine,
very quick
four.
On that.
Big, powerful man, Wang. Oh. Interesting results for Wang Tzu Wei.
5-9.
At a purple patch. Shortly after the German Open, so that would have been around April last year, winning the New Zealand Open, which was a Grand Prix also. Yep, the New Zealand Open and semi-final at the Osaka Challenge. Semi-final at the Iran International Challenge. But a pretty poor run of form in the last couple of tournaments.
Six,
probably the reason why he's come to Europe, just trying to get some consistency back again. That's another racket gone. At least a string gone. Beaten in the last 16 of the Korean Grand Prix, the Chinese Taipei Open, and the Yonex US Open. Man, the Yonex US Open this year, the longest name I've ever heard in a tournament.
Nine.
Its full title, the 2014 Yonex Suffolk County Community College US Open Championships. And breathe. Good smash from Lind.
Good rally all round there.
7-9.
Both players taking a breather.
A little bit more justified than some of the breaks we've seen, though.
You know, you don't mind the odd one, Leon, when you have a rally like that.
Yeah.
But man, when they come after every rally or every second rally, it's really just
frustrating.
Completely frustrating.
7,
the rule
9.
Of continuous play just goes out the door.
Oh. this over.
It's another call. I'm not at all sure about
seven.
See this again. No, can't see it. It's pushed long there, but this game has come to life a bit in the last three or four points. Quality raised on both sides of the net.
Yeah, Wang with the interval lead, a 4-point advantage for the Chinese Taipei shuttler. You can see Yoak in person has come to sit alongside Christian Lin Thompson. Both of them have spent some time training with Michael Kjeldsen in the International Badminton Academy. Complain about the lack of experience of the line judges at the Scottish Open. Face of Ellen Howard, who is actually a director on the board of Badminton Scotland. And just shows you they're willing to come down and get stuck in and get called the lines. And probably one of the most consistent line judges, to be fair to her.
Yeah.
Back to the action.
Yeah, that's wide. Yeah.
I think the line judge took her time to make that call. It was certainly the right call. Played with such venom. The smash cross court. A long way out in badminton terms. Good call. And Lind just hanging in there. Little double action. Deceptive return of serve from Wang.
Very confident that was going out, and it's landed right on the line. Surely that was called out.
Service over.
It's been a long day.
Yeah.
Nine.
Yeah.
But it was certainly out. And I don't think Christian Lin Thompson had any argument anyway. He knew it was out.
No, it's...
Service over.
10, 15.
He certainly overhit that, because that's the slow end.
I think Wang certainly went with the intention of pushing that into the body of Lind.
Yeah, it's just a little careless again. Be close though.
Yeah, he ran into that 4-point lead.
Yeah.
While leading 5-point lead, while leading 9-4, and Lind did close it to within 2 at 1 point. But Wang just keeping his nose in front.
12-16.
Defense. Oh, and in the end, Christian needing the net to help him win the point.
No. Service over. Service over.
Didn't go over. He didn't win the point.
Oh, didn't go over.
No.
I was full sure it went over.
He should have won the point. He had plenty of chances.
See it there? Oh, yeah, falling back inside of the net.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly, Leon. He had enough chances to win it. Beautiful cross net again from Wang. Oh. 18-12, and a welcome towel down for both men. 15 minutes gone.
And silent support in the corner for Lind, but not much input there.
18-12 on the ground.
Yeah, he's having to work hard to pick up points here.
13-18.
Another break in play. Sometimes I wonder, you know, you see the player going down, and yeah, justifiably so, needs to.
Well, when you go down, I think your whole body's on the court. The court does get very wet.
Of course it does,
sweat.
Yeah. And it's, in this case, you know, it's happening, you know, only every few rallies, and it's justifiable that it needs mopping. But surely the line judge should have the power
13,
just to
18.
Get up as soon as it happens and be over there to mop as ready as soon as the player gets up, rather than having to wait for the umpire to call.
Yeah. Let's wait.
Service over. 19, 13.
I think some of the confusion over line calls with the Ellen Howard that you mentioned earlier, she is moving her hands to give the out, but she's below the board.
Yeah, she's below the board. So she's below the level, yeah.
Yeah, you can't really see her.
A little double action from Wang.
Oh! Service over. 14-19.
And Lynn just hanging in there, Leon. He's not giving it to Wang easily.
He's not, but quite a lot of his points are just coming from mistakes, unforced errors from Wang. I don't think Lynn's really like that one. I don't think Lynn's really putting him under any pressure.
19,
it's just
19.
Picking up the scraps. Again, very tight net shot to bring up the game point.
15. So in 18 minutes, as Leon said, game point for Wang Tzu Wei.
Was well picked up, but in the end, easy enough to knock off.
16-20. Net from both players in this
game.
Yeah.
Set, but in the end a powerful smash across the body from Christian Lin.
Game won by Wang Tzu Wei, 21-16.
Wang Tzu Wei taking the first game 21-16 in 20 minutes.
So do you see any change coming in the second game? You think there's much Lin can do to turn this around?
You can see Lin. I don't think Christian Lind has too many plan Bs. He plays, and he's played the same way all his life, really.
Yeah.
Likes to rally, and does like to get involved at the net now and again, but you could see clearly in some of the points, certainly towards the end, when he took Wang on at the net, and Wang very comfortable. And
yeah.
In the end, it was Lind giving way and playing the lift.
Yeah. Difficult to see what he can do, really. It doesn't look to me as though he has enough to really challenge Wang.
Customary change of shirt for Christian Lin.
Second game, love all.
Second game underway. Little brush.
One.
And the shuttle just catching the net cord as it tumbled over. First point to Wang.
Oh, come on. service over.
Decent rally that time from Lind.
One all.
Yeah, and Wang content at the end there just to take that shot in the backhand. Looked to me like they actually had plenty of time to go around it.
Nice change of pace from Lind. Snatching at it, Christian Lind.
Two, all.
Yeah, nice angle on that smash. Very close to the line. Difficult to read. Difficult to get to. These young Asian players, they have a different life to the Europeans, don't they? You know, this doesn't happen the other way around. You get Asian players coming here on their own, you know, trying to establish themselves and move up the world rankings. Because the standard is so high in Asia, it's very difficult for them to do it there. European players can't do that simply because they wouldn't get in the draw in Asian tournaments.
Exactly. So. You see this rally? Wang playing the whole rally with two broken strings. He's a thud off his racket. Still managing to continue on. And in the end, no chance.
Service over. Three, all.
That's the third racket he's gone through this match, isn't it?
Exactly. He's gone into the reserve of his bag now.
I wonder who he'll be able to borrow from if he runs out. This is the first time he's been ahead in the match, Mark. 4-3.
Yep.
Slender 1-point lead, but gives him some hope.
No, got ahead early on in the very beginning of the first game, led 2-1. Right. That was as good as it got in the first.
That was good though, he read that well, moved in on it, and killed it.
5-3.
loose. Yeah.
You know, that was a tired looking shot, to be fair. And he looks a little bit like Wang on court in the second game. This one goes to three games. Yes. Leon, we could be here for the long haul. We saw earlier on Christian Lynn Thompson's match, the longest match of the day so far, extending to almost 70 minutes.
Now that's depressing. You're right, it's possible.
Yeah, it is possible. Sure is possible.
Now built up a 4-point lead here, and Wang's definitely gone off the boil. Mm-hmm.
It's always the way in the last match of the day. Ends up going to the three games. Extending over an hour. Like Christian Lin doing his best to help us out.
That's the right idea there. He just overhits it. It's a clear area of court.
Clever change of direction. Wang putting it in behind Christian Lind, and Lind forced a pirouette onto the backhand side. Smash. Certainly, Lind looked to be playing the smash from half court, so should have really put that one away.
He got up high for it too. It's just a little bit careless. That's a 4-point lead disappeared very quickly, back to 7-all. Yeah. And he can't be happy with that because it wasn't because of anything in particular that Wang did. I think it's just
series of errors.
Three careless errors, yeah.
Christian Lin not happy with that call.
Well, if it was out, it was excellent judgment by Wang because it can't be more than a millimeter in it.
Very close. Wang at full stretch. Service forward called.
Just become a little bit patchy now, this mark in the middle of this set. Errors on both sides. And they both actually look a little bit tired. As you said, it's getting late in the evening. They've both had matches earlier in the day.
And I'm going to go back to the new experimental scoring system just for a bit. And again, the few tournaments I've been at, because it seems to be a quicker game, the time between the points was also speeded up with the players because there was an urgency to win and get to 11.
Yeah.
And this feel here in the 21 system, we're gone back to a reasonably decent rally, and then there's more time taken between the rallies than actually playing the game. And it's, you know, as somebody who lives and breathes badminton, it's difficult for me to get up for a match like this.
I can understand yes. Yeah.
So how can you expect people who are not really into the game to really come and enjoy it and watch it when there are too many lows and too much downtime in the game? Interval lead for Wang, just a solitary single point.
I think there's scope within the existing rules, though, for dealing with the amount of downtime. You know, it's just that court officials are not always willing to stick to the letter of the law, not willing to impose the regulations on players. I actually noticed that in this level of tournament Grand Prix, and probably the level below the circuit tournaments, more time is taken than the top players take in Super Series matches. You know, I think there's more of a, quite often there's more of a flow.
Probably, but certainly, say in my time involved in professional badminton, which is about 10 years odd, you know, the time between the points is just steadily and consistently just getting longer and longer, longer. You know, 10 years ago it was quite quick. Or even when the 21 system came in, whatever it was, whatever year it was.
Yeah.
You know, there's still an urgency between the points. From my perspective, from a commentator's perspective, for somebody who talks about the game, I found myself being very much more involved in matches.
Yeah, when there's a flow, there's no doubt, yeah.
With the 11 system and... and that's just probably me being more excited about it, because there is more excitement in it. Anyway, enough about that. That decision will come when it comes. Of course, if it does come, it has to come before the start of the qualification period for the Olympics, which starts in May. But the testing period now finished, of course. Yeah, well left.
14, 10.
And 4 points in a row. While I was talking about the new experimental scoring system. Yeah. It was 10-all and now I've turned back and it's 14-10.
I was wondering what Wang was going to do there if that had been in, because he'd run round it to take it on his forehand, leaving the whole court entirely exposed.
He must have been confident it was out.
He must have been, yeah.
And making sure he was getting out of the way of the line judge. As the Emirates Arena empties out, the adjoining match finished on court, and this men's singles the last match.
11-14.
Seeing that instance, if I was in the chair, and this is why I'm not an umpire.
To be fair to them, that was quite a long rally.
Yeah, but that's what they're here to do.
Yeah,
they're
it is.
To play badminton, and they're here if they have a long rally. Yeah. It's sometimes it's about conditioning, it's about your fitness, and it shouldn't be allowed. You have a break at 11, get on with it. That's my opinion. Okay, there's certain times, you know, and there's so many times I see, say, the interval break, which it is, and that to me is almost too long anyway. But silly breaks at 19 all.
I think it's a commentator's point of view. I think players would say, look at what goes on in tennis. Yeah, you know, a break after every single point.
I'm sick of people looking at tennis when they talk about badminton. We cannot compare, 15, we cannot even discuss tennis. Can I ask him what? The problem is, for most part, and you can't disagree with me in this, Leon, for most part, the breaks in play have become tactical.
I agree with that, absolutely.
And there are times, yes, when you see these exhausting rallies and they deserve the break.
It was that one particular break where they had a long rally. That's where I disagreed with you.
No. It's very, very quickly after the interval. And the shuttle went missing.
Yeah.
And they're not sure which one, so it's...
They should just be changing it.
Get a new shuttle, guys.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Anyway, rant over. 15-11. 38 minutes played.
Service
and Lind
over.
Battling his way back into 12, it again, just trading 15. By three now. Nice control on the net shot from Wang. Beautiful backhand. Yes. And that lift.
It's lifted
well
out
too
the back.
Long,
yeah.
13,
and the Dane back.
15.
Within touching distance.
Wang again just looking a little unsure of himself now.
Yeah, certainly had an opportunity to kill off the match when he had that 4-point advantage.
He had, yeah.
Christian Lynn Thompson, one of these players that just never seems to go away. Oh.
Yeah, good smash into the body. Right choice, I think.
15 all.
And from nowhere, the Dane levels it up again at 15 all. Getting close to 3/4 hour now, and not two sets finished.
No. What's worse, your predictions in jeopardy now?
It sure is. Some men's doubles. Again.
Service over.
I'm just thinking twice and then deciding to
16,
leave.
15.
See it on the replay.
Right decision.
Right decision and well out.
That's well in. Yeah.
Service over. 16 all.
I think Wang getting a little bit lucky. Not once, but twice.
Twice, yeah.
Service over.
That net shot that he played was going to drift out, only for it hit the net and sort of pulled it back in. and then sticking out a racket.
Yeah. Not at all sure he was going to connect with it either, I don't think. Just very lucky on that one.
Christian Lind almost defeathering the shuttle on the half volley when he scampered back.
He's very careless.
Yeah, that's it. 17. A lot of careless has come into the play right
now.
He
does look tired to me, though. Why?
Yeah. Of course, Grand Prix. These players playing two matches today.
Yeah.
One earlier, and you know, having to regroup and come back quite late in the evening. Still only half nine. You know, we often see at other events matches going on at midnight.
There.
17.
So Lind pulls a point ahead.
Wang looking for a change of shuttle. Christian Lind adamant. The shuttle is in decent condition.
Lovely shot.
Yeah, that just clipped the line.
18 all.
Again, another. We'll see it on the replay.
Yeah. No.
It was in. Just about. But in. Sublime net from Wang, really comfortable the front court. And Lind just happy to soak up the pressure. Patient play from the Dane. This beautiful brush at the net. And you can tell Christian Lind very happy with the outcome. Still impossible to call this set. Two game points, Christian Lind Thompson.
Yeah, takes it at the first time of asking. Yeah.
Second game, one.
So we go into a third and final set.
21-18, one game all.
And that's the umpire calls it one game all. 21-16 in the first for Wang. And a spirited comeback and fight back. Lind was trailing 15 10 and 1 point.
Well, it's going to come down to who wants it the most now, because they do both look quite physically tired now to me.
Another change of shirt for Christian Lind Thompson.
Twenty seconds.
A lot of tired bodies in the hall. And of course, we've been here for 3 days streaming this event. And this is the final match in our streaming calendar. Did qualification day one yesterday in this
final game.
Quarterfinal, third round quarterfinal day. The very last set, 48 minutes on the clock. Again, Lynn scampering. Somehow, Wang getting a racquet on it and finding the space over the head of Lind.
Yeah, getting a racquet on it and having the wrist strength to get it back over his head. It's good defense.
Another point that Lind needed in this game.
1-3.
Certainly a tired looking shot.
Yeah.
Leon.
Service over.
That was a well constructed point though for Lynn.
2-4. Service over.
I just feel Lynn, he has to stay in touch in the first half of this third end, I think, to have any chance. He needs to be within a point or two when you get to the break in this match, so probably better not to read too much into it yet.
Yeah, certainly. Christian Lynn getting a good lead at the beginning of the second game and then losing it. And then Wang getting a 5-point lead after the interval. In the second game, Lind coming right back. It was a very very difficult to read anything at this point, I think.
Oh. That looked to me like it was going wide.
Three, six.
I think he's realised it now. Shot there.
7-3.
You know, the other men's singles semi-finalists have played a couple of hours ago.
They'll be loving this.
Yeah, they'll be loving it for sure. They're all at home, more than likely chewing on a nice meal and chilling out, or even in bed at this
maybe,
point.
Maybe, maybe by now, yeah.
So this match has to be over in 15 minutes.
I think that does only refer to the public areas. The building.
9-3.
The only thing is, following on from that conversation, Leon, is that the men's singles and the winner of this won't have to play before 4 p.m. tomorrow, so
right, yeah,
it'll tend to even itself out. First men's singles is the fourth match on after midday. Oh, that looked like it clipped the line. Yeah,
it did. Yeah.
Service over. 4-10.
But certainly, the winner of this plays Anand Pavar. And Pavar, I think, was victorious over Yuhan Tan, which seems like a long time ago at this stage.
Yeah.
So he certainly has a few hours advantage in terms of recuperation.
He did at least have a... He was a three-set match as well, wasn't it? Yeah. And the shuttle feathers flying there. Mm-hmm.
5-10.
So Lind only just hanging on here. Another one, I'm sure he'll be looking for at least one more point before the interval to feel that he's still in contention.
Again, an example of super defense, but the speed at which they recover.
Yeah.
To get up and keep going in the rally. Oh, man, ooh, that was a wild, wild.
Service over.
Smash.
11-6.
I think
at some point, I'm sure he feels he should have won.
Certainly, I'm just wondering, did he hurt himself in that rally, Christian Lind? But it's Lind, it's Wang who takes the interval lead, and a decent lead at this point in the game. And just take this opportunity just to look ahead to the semi-finals tomorrow. First game on court will be midday. It'll be men's doubles, and that'll be followed by the women's singles. I think that everyone wants to see. We top seed Kirsty Gilmour against Sayaka Sato, who was very impressive.
20 seconds. 20 seconds.
And then more Scottish interest straight after with Blair and Bankier, the top seeds in the mixed doubles. Then we have the first of the men's single semi-finals, Zawadzki, who has somehow managed to find his way to the semi-final after struggling through so many matches against Villa Lang, the fourth seed. Men's doubles will follow that. Women's doubles and mixed doubles. And of course, if you're in the Glasgow area, get yourself down. Leon, tickets always available on the door.
Certainly are, yes. Should be a great day's badminton. There are lots of interesting matches, I think, in this lineup, especially from the home point of view.
And certainly semi-finals and finals day, always exciting.
Yeah.
At the Scottish Open. Remember, it won't be streamed live. It'll be TV will be here recording for highlights reels that will be shown later in the week. So if you want to see the Scottish Open Grand Prix, get yourself down to the Emirates Arena. Just starting to sense that this is now drifting away from Lind.
Well, it should now from 12-6. I think Wang would have to do something seriously wrong to throw away this lead.
Need a 5-point lead around the same time of the second game. But certainly I would expect him now to...
I think the level of fatigue now in both players is considerably higher than it was then. I think it's mentally for Lind now in the final set, 12-6 down, quite tough.
Service over.
Given a cheap point there though.
12.
As you say, Wang has been guilty of just easing up when he's been ahead. Mm-hmm. So it could happen again.
Service over. 13-7. Service over. 8-13.
You can see the frustration with himself there in Wang's face in that close up.
Still, he hangs in there.
Yeah, he does.
And as I said about Christian Lind, he just doesn't go away.
I do think in this match he's being allowed to hang in there quite a lot. That's another lovely brush.
Certainly, Wang has his peaks 14. And troughs and a peak again and. You know, it's extraordinary when I look at the statistics of the match. Lind, if you take it percentage-wise, it's probably only been ahead for about 10% of the match.
Yeah.
And he's still hanging in there in the third game.
Service over.
Oh, man, that must have hurt.
Service over. 15.
Another break.
10.
Coming up.
It will be. I think the umpire is asking if all parts are still in working order there, Mark.
Yeah, I think so.
Showing concern.
He certainly lunged, jumped forward and landed with a thump on the court.
Bounces back to take the next point.
11:15.
5 minutes past the hour on court. Taking it late.
Yeah. Service over. 16-11.
And Wang with enough left in his legs to get in quickly for the kill.
You'd be surprised how quickly, you know, how you can just revitalize. Yeah. Once the opportunity presents itself, you're amazing how the lactic acid just disappears.
Yes.
Service over.
The brain certainly not working on that occasion for Wang.
12-16.
It's amazing when you look at the first game. Wang effectively led from start to finish. In the second, Christian Lind had a proper patch at the beginning where he had a 4-point advantage. And then it wasn't until the end when he got 18-17 ahead that he led again and had a few points to take the second game. And then in the third game, Wang has been ahead from start to finish.
He has, but there's another soft header there.
Yeah,
he's just allowing Lind that little glimmer of hope.
Lind has spent the majority of this hour and 5 minutes coming from behind.
Service over. 17-13.
I think this next point is the one.
This is a big point.
Yeah. If Wang wins this,
he should get enough confidence, enough energy.
Yeah, and even playing bad, he should struggle over the line. If Lind wins it, he's right back in it again.
That's wide. So, he does make it.
18.
Yep, 5 points.
Yeah. Only 3 to go.
68 minutes on the clock. One hour and 11 minutes was Christian Lind's earlier third-round match against Toby 13. Penty.
Yeah, that takes out of you. And you can see now he's tired.
Mm.
His head's gone down.
And already 1 hour 8 in this quarter-final match against Wang Tzu Wei.
Nice shot, though.
Yeah.
Service over. 14-19. Thank
you.
So you're grudging them this break, Mark?
No, no.
Have they earned this one?
I was thinking about it. I was battling with myself in my own brain and thinking, come on, guys, get the hell out of it. But yeah, it's 69 minutes.
You've probably done enough.
You've probably done enough. You've earned this one. Yeah.
14, 19, play.
Oh, unlucky, I think, that time.
Service over.
And after 20, pretty much 70
match
minutes,
point, 14.
It's Wang Tzu Wei who reaches match point. It's not over yet. A nice stick smash
over
from Lynn.
15, 20.
I have to tell you, Mark, I play in a regular four where one of the players frequently takes an extended break after the first point. We tend to have long rallies.
Yeah, and that's it eventually. 71 minutes played, exactly the same time as his earlier match. Christian Lynn Thompson, for this one, coming out the wrong side of a three-game scoreline. Wang goes through to meet Anand Pavar in tomorrow's semi-final at 4 o'clock.
Match won by Wang.
I would say he's going to have to up his level a little bit if he's going to come through that one.
Yeah, I'm certainly revising.
It was patchy, that performance. Yeah,
I fancied him before this match. I'm revising that now. I think Pavar will exploit any weakness and he'd have to play at his highest level for all his match to beat him. With three games, 21-16, 18-21, 21-15, and that's the end of our coverage here at the Scottish Open Grand Prix in Glasgow, the Emirates Arena. It's our pleasure being with you for the last 3 days. TV take over tomorrow, of course, and of course you can watch any highlights from the semi-finals and finals during the week, I think on Thursday of next week, an hour package of highlights. All that's left for me to say is to thank all my co-commentators, Dan, Rita, Ray, and of course Leon. Thank you very much for sitting in and staying here so late this evening. And special thanks to all the guys behind the scenes. Put in some great work. Superb camera work. All the guys on sound. And certainly all the players who've given us great value and great entertainment over the 3 days. I've been Mark Phelan, and until next time, hopefully next year maybe, goodbye.
Thank God.
That was right.
Yeah, it'll slick you back there, and now it's like...